Friends, I hope you are doing well and completing your work with the help of question answers that we are providing to you. Now, today I will explain you lesson 7 of science classics, that is, getting to know plants. First of all, let's take a view on the topics we will cover in this chapter. So in this chapter, we will learn about herbs, shrubs and trees, that is different types of plants, parts of flowering plants, root system means function of root and their modification, and shoot system that includes stem, leaf, flowers, seeds, fruits and their functions. So today's topic is plants. We know so many things about plants, and what are the things that we know? That plants are also living things. They are mostly in green in color. They are found in gardens, fields, crops, on the roadsides, all of our of different kind of plants. Leaf of plants, shape of flowers, color of flowers and size of stems, etc. So some of the plants bear flowers. They are called flowering plants, like rose, mango, sunflower. And some plants do not bear flowers, so they are called non-flowering plants or flowerless plants, like mushroom, mosses, ferns, pine trees. They are considered in non-flowering plants because these plants doesn't bear the flowers. So plants are of different size. So as per their sizes, we call them in with two different names, that the ones which is small, you call them as plant, and the ones big, you call as tree. But if these naming is scientific, shall we call the smaller ones as plants and the bigger ones as trees? Or there is any systematic way to coding the plants? So let's find out. On the basis of their size, shape and lifespan, plants are divided into three types: herbs, shrubs and trees. First, see about herbs. Herbs, plants with green and tender stems called herbs. Like they do not contain woody stems. Herbs are a small plant having soft and delicate stem, and the stem of herbs are juicy and fleshy. They are short sized plants and do not grow more than 1 meter in height. Like you have seen the basil, means tulsi, mint, bay leaf, coriander. They have the short size plants. Now shrubs. Shrubs are medium sized plant with a hard and woody stem, branching out near the base, and they are less than 3 meter tall. Shrubs survive for many years, but their lifespan are less than trees like henna, lemon, guava, hibiscus. They all are considered as shrubs. They are found in gardens and they mainly used for the decorative purpose. Now about trees. See, herbs are the small plant, short size. Shrubs are the medium size plant. And trees, they are very tall and have hard and thick brown stem called as trunk. And several branches arises from that stem or trunk. So trees are the largest of all plants. In fact, trees are largest of all living things, like mango tree, neem tree, apple tree, peepal tree. They all are considered tree because they are very tall. Now apart from these three basic classification, plants are also classified into climber and creepers. Creepers. Some plants with weak stem need support, so they cannot stand upright by their own and spread on the ground, called creepers. Like pumpkin, watermelon, muskmelon, they are the example of creepers. They cannot stand upright. And about climbers. Climbers are the plant that take support on the neighboring structure like wall, trees, fence and climb up. so they are called climbers. They also have long and weak stem. Both climber and creepers have long and weak stem. The difference is the creepers spread on the ground and the climbers, with the help of neighboring support, they climb up. Like peas, bitter gourd, money plant, bean plant, they are considered as climbers. Now, on the basis of their lifespan or life cycle, plants are classified into three main types: annual plants, biennial plants, and perennial plants. Annual plants, plants whose life cycle is completed in one season, like wheat and mustard. They need only one season to complete their life cycle. Biennial plants, like carrot and radish, potato also, their life cycle required two seasons for completion. Means their life cycle completed in two seasons. They are called biennial plants. Now, perennial plants, plants whose life cycle runs for more than two seasons, like guava, babul, palm trees, they are considered in perennial plants. Now, parts of flowering plants. You see the number of plants bearing flowers like rose, pansy, marigold, they are the flowering plants. So flowering plants are the most important group of plants inhabiting the earth, and they carry out the different functions. See the diagram that display on your screen. The most of the flowering plants have two systems, root system and shoot system. The part of plant which remains below the soil is called root system, and the part of plant which is above the soil is called shoot system. Like in diagram, it is given that root system have primary root and secondary root. And shoot system, it includes bud, flower, leaf, fruit and stem. So first of all, we will discuss about root system. Root system consists of roots and its branches. So the first root is developed from seed is called the primary root, and the primary root produces many branches called secondary roots, and the branches that arise from the main root is called lateral roots. Main root is the primary root. Okay, according to these kinds, root system may be of two types: tap root system and fibrous root system. See in diagram, it is given tap root. The main root, which is larger and fast growing, is called tap root. Means one main root is present from which several secondary roots are arises, like carrot, radish you have seen, mango also. And about fibrous root, in this no main root is present and all the roots are of same size, like coconut, wheat, grass you have seen. So the difference between tap root and fibrous root is that the tap root consists the main root along which the several small roots are arises, and in fibrous root no main roots are present and all roots are found or arises as a bunch of same size. And now, what are the functions of root and why it is important? Root helps to anchor the plant of the soil. Anchor, hold or attach the plant to the soil. It absorbs water and minerals from the soil to help the plants to grow. And the root helps to prevent soil erosion. Prevent soil erosion means the roots hold the soil together. In this way, the soil is safe from being blown off by the winds or wash away by water. Does the root help to prevent the soil erosion? So these are the three main functions of root: anchor the plant to the soil, absorb water and minerals from the soil, and to prevent the soil erosion. Now, in some plants, roots perform special functions. Means apart from these three main functions, They perform special functions and their structure changes. These changes are called modification. So the important modifications that are found in roots are to store food and to give additional support to plants. First is about to store food. You may see the carrot, radish, turnip, they are of swollen and thick they are. Why? Because beside of their normal functions, they also serve to store food prepared by plants. And they store food so that the plant use it in unfavorable condition. So they are called tuberous root. Now how they modified for support? You have seen the banyan trees. These roots grow from branches and go into the soil. In banyan trees, aerial roots are present. They look like columns of buildings and give support to the branches of banyan trees. And these are often called as prop roots. Okay, clear about the root system? Now let's move on to the shoot system. See, this diagram shows the different parts that we include in the shoot system. It consists of stem, branches, leaf, flowers, fruits and seeds. So first discuss about stem. Stem, the main axis of the shoot system. It grows above or upward direction from the soil. The places on the stem where the leaf grows, the place of the stem from where leaf arises are known as nodes. And the portion of the stem between two nodes are called internodes. Okay, now the place of the stem from where leaf arise are called nodes. And the portion of the stem between the two nodes is called internodes. Now what is the function of stem? Stem keeps the plants erect. It supports the branches and leaves in such a way that the leaves are properly exposed to sunlight and air for they carry out the photosynthesis and respiration. And see this diagram, it shows the process of transportation. Transportation, the water and minerals absorbed by the roots are conducted upward by the stem to branches, leaves, etc., other parts of the plant. And it also conducts the prepared food downward from the leaves to the other parts of the plant. So it helps in the transportation of food and water. And the green stem synthesizes food for the plant by photosynthesis. In some plants, stems are in green in color and they synthesize food for the plants. So basically the four main functions of stems are that it provides support to the plant, it bears important parts of plant, it helps in transportation of food and water, and the green stem synthesizes food for the plant by the process of photosynthesis. Now in stems of some plant do carry out some additional functions besides these three, four functions, and they become the modified. So here the modification of stems. Stems are modified for storage of food, for support, for photosynthesis and for protection. First is stems modified for storage of food. See in diagram it is given ginger and potato. They store food, stems store food by the plant during unfavorable conditions. Like potato, onion, ginger, they are example of underground stems and they modified for storage of food. Next, stems modified for support. The plants that bear the weak stems like climbers and creepers, the stems are converted into tendrils. Tendrils are present here for the support for climbing. You might have seen the thin, wiry, spiral curl branch or structure present in pea plant or grapevine. They are called tendrils. So the stems are modified for support. Notch stems are modified for photosynthesis. In desert, amount of water is too low, so the stem prepare food for the plant. This is because the leaves are modified into spines to prevent the loss of water. Loss of water is a process of transpiration. We will discuss this later. So the leaves are converted into spines. So now the stems made the food for plant by the process of photosynthesis. Example for this is cactus or many desert plants. Next is stems are modified for protection. In some plants, thorns develop in the axil of leaves. They are hard, straight and sharp pointed structure. They develop for the protection of plant. You have seen thorns present in rose plant. Now next is leaf. Leaf arises the node and arises from the nodes and has a bud in the axil. Leaves are of green in color and flat structure. They may have many shapes like round, long, thin as shown in figure. And the needle of the evergreen trees are leaves. Now first we will discuss about the parts of leaves. See in diagram it is shown that these are the different parts of the leaves. The leaf has the three main parts. The board, flat green part of the leaf is called lamina or leaf blade. It tips is called leaf apex and the edge of the lamina is called margin. Now the stalk of the leaf means the part from where the leaf arrives is called petiole. And the petiole continues in the leaf as a midrib. Now midrib branches into the thread-like structure called veins. So these are the basic parts of the leaves: midrib, margin, lamina, petiole and veins. See, first importance lamina. The broad, flat, green part of the leaf is called lamina. Its tip is called leaf apex. The edge of the lamina is called margin. The stalk of the leaf is called petiole and the petiole continues in leaf as midrib. The midrib branches into thread-like structure called veins. Now the function of vein is to transport water and minerals through the leaves. The design or pattern made by veins in a leaf is called leaf venation. Now on the basis of leaf venation, we can differentiate it into palar venation and reticulate venation. At the diagram, see, it is given. If the design of vein is palar, then it is called palar venation. And if the design of vein is like a net, then it is called reticulate venation. See, palar venation you have seen in grass and reticulate venation, rose, guava. Okay. To find out that the roots are fibrous or taproot, you have to dig it out the plant. Like if you want to see the type of root present in grass, you have to dig out the grass and then see it is taproot or fibrous root. So one important note is here that on the basis of leaf venation, you can identify the types of root. Means if palar venation are present, then the plant bear the fibrous root, and if reticulate venations are present, then plants is of tap root. So this you have to learn, that fibrous root palar venation and tap roots reticulate venation. Now there are two types of leaves: simple leaf and compound leaf. In simple leaf, the lamina is not divided into segment, means the lamina is whole or is in entire. Like in mango, sunflower, they consist of the simple leaf. Now in case of compound leaf, The lamina is divided into segment called leaflet. You have seen neem, rose, gulmohar. They all are the example of compound leaves. They bear the leaflets. Now, the function of leaf. Leaf perform the following important function, and that two main functions are photosynthesis and transpiration. Photosynthesis, all of you know the photosynthesis, that on the upper part of the leaf they are present a number of small opening or pores. These small pores are present on the leaf surface. These are called stomata, and stomata help in exchange of gases, which is intake. Intake means plants intake the carbon dioxide and release oxygen in the presence of water and sunlight by the presence of process of photosynthesis. So the first function of that is photosynthesis. Second is transpiration. Transpiration means water vapor are released into the atmosphere through stomata present on leaf. See this diagram. These droplets are coming out of leaf through the stomata. That loss of water from the surface of leaves. This process is called transpiration. Okay. And the leaves, the main purpose of leaf is for making food by the process of photosynthesis. So it is also called the food factory of plant, as it is responsible for making food for the plant. Okay. Now in some plants, leaves are also modified to carry out some additional functions apart from these two, photosynthesis and transpiration. Now these are the modifications of leaves. Leaves are modified to give support, leaves are modified for protection, and leaves are modified for vegetative propagation. First is to give support. As earlier I told you about tendrils, that is spiral structure present, those plant having weak stems. So leaves are modified into tendrils, so the plants climb up for support, like sweet pea. You have seen the tendrils. Now modified for protection. The leaves of desert plant, it are reduced into spines. So the spines are pointed structure which also protect the plant from eaten by the grazing animals, like in cactus, date palm. Now leaves are modified for vegetative propagation. Vegetative propagation is the method to regenerate the plant parts, a complete plant, by taking the help of any plant part. Like in this method, we will use leaf. For example, in bryophyllum. Bryophyllum is a plant. The buds develop on the surface of leaf margin, and these buds give out fibrous root. And the roots of the lower leaves strike the soil and give rise to the new plant. So with the help of leaf, that root arises and it gives rise to the new plant. So it is modified for vegetative propagation. Now next is flower. Flower is the most attractive part of the flowering plant. Means all flowers are not same. They may differ in shape, size, color or fragrance. Flowers like hibiscus and dahlia have bright colors, and rows of flowers have the color as well as fragrance. And the flowers, you have seen the jasmine, that have the excellent fragrance. And due to the different color of flowers, we are able to recognize the plant. Now see the structure of flower. The flower is attached to the stem with the help of a stalk called pedicel. Now the uppermost part of the pedicel is called thalamus, and it bears all the flower floral parts. And the typical flower has four main parts: sepal, petal, stamen and carpel. Carpel are also known as pistil. So the different parts of flowers are petals, sepals, carpel and stamen. We will discuss one by one. Okay, first is petal and sepal. Petals. These are the brightly colored. The petals are very enormous in shape and the main function of petal is to attract insect and birds to the flower. Means basically the color part of the flower that covers the reproductive part of the flower is called petals. Now sepal. Sepals are the green, small, leaf-like structure which protect the flower when it is in bud form. Mainly or usually flower contains 5 sepals, but number may be less or more. And generally sepals are green, but in some cases like in gulmohar, the sepals are of red color. Now stamen and carpel. Inside the petals are stamens. Stamens are the male part of the flower and it has 2 parts, filaments and anther. The stamen is made up of a long filament with an anther at the top and the anther contains pollen grains. See the structure of stamen. Filaments are present and anther, and in between the anther, pollen grains are present. And carpel. Carpel is the female part of the flower, also known as pistil, and it has 3 parts, stigma, style and ovary. It is given in figure. Stigma, style and ovary. Inside the ovary, ovules are present. Now there are 6 types of flowers on the basis of their structure. We can classify it like complete flower, incomplete flower, bisexual flower, unisexual flower, actinomorphic flower and zygomorphic flower. It is easier to learn it in pair, like complete and incomplete flower. First we will discuss it. Complete flower. A flower which contains sepal, petals, stamens and pistil. Pistil means carpels. Is said to be complete, means if all the 4 important parts are present in the flower, then the flower are complete. Like in cotton, flower of cotton is the example of complete flower. Incomplete flower, if one of the 4 main parts of the flower is missing, if any one of that 4 parts, any one of it missing, then it is called incomplete flower, like in cucurbits. Now, it is then about complete and incomplete. Means if all the 4 parts of flower are present, then it is complete flower. If any one of the main 4 parts is missing, then the flower is said to be incomplete. Now, bisexual and unisexual flower. If the male part and female part, male part means stamen, female parts means carpel or pistil, are present in the same flower, then such flower is called as bisexual flower, like in sunflower. In sunflower, male and female both parts are present in same flower. Now in unisexual, if stamen and pistil are not found on the same flower, means they have the different flower for their parts, it is called the unisexual flower, like in coconut. Now next is actinomorphic and zygomorphic flower. Actinomorphic flower, these flowers can be bisected into similar half along 2 or more planes. If we can bisect the flower along with 2 or more planes, then it is called actinomorphic flower, like Dhatura. And if the flowers can be bisected into similar half only in 1 plane, then it is called zygomorphic flower, like Pisum sativum. Clear about actinomorphic and zygomorphic? If we can bisect the flower only in 1 plane, then it is zygomorphic. If we can bisect into similar half along with two or more planes, then it is actinomorphic flower. Okay, so these are the six types of flowers. Now function of flowers. Flowers are the reproductive organ of the plant and they produce fruits and seeds which help in reproduction. So the two main functions of flower is that it bears the reproductive organ, that male and female part, and it produces the fruit and seeds for that they help in reproduction. Now for a flower to develop into a fruit and form seeds, means flower have to develop into fruit and they have to form seeds, pollen grain must be transferred from anther to stigma. So see this diagram, it shows the process of pollination. The process of transfer of pollen grain from anther to stigma is called pollination, and it can be transferred through water, wind and animals. This diagram, animals means bird or insect. This diagram shows the pollination through insect, this butterfly. So with the help of this butterfly, the pollen grain of anther is transferred into stigma, and then consider the further process of fertilization. Now fruits. All flowering plants produce fruit. So the mature ovary develop into fruit. Like you have seen orange, apples, they have the fleshy fruits. Whereas the peas, nuts, they are the dry fruits. So you can easily classify or identify fleshy fruits or dry fruits. Functions of fruits. Fruits enclose the seeds and thus protect them from injury. That seeds are present inside the fruits. So it protect the seeds from injury and from the effect of unfavorable condition, means heat, rains, these. And certain fruits like mango, apple, chiku or watermelon, they store food for plant. And fruits are eaten by man and animals, so they help in the dispersal of seeds. Now about seed, like the mature ovary develop into fruit and the mature ovules develop into seeds. A seed contain a baby plant or embryo. A seed has an endosperm and a seed coat. The endosperm contain the store food which is used by embryo, and the seed coat work is to protect the embryo. Okay, so that seed has endosperm and seed coat. Endosperm has the store food and seed coat protect the embryo. Now the embryo has two or more leaves called cotyledons. On the basis of this, these are two types, monocotyledons and dicotyledons. The plants that have seeds with one cotyledons are called monocotyledons, like rice, maize. And the plants that have seeds with two cotyledons are called dicotyledons, like pea, beans, gram. Easily by breaking it, you can see that it's disperse into two. It shows the dicotyledons of it. Now see the diagram. An embryo has a tiny root called a radicle and a tiny stem called the plumule. See, it is given in diagram, radicle and plumule. The radicle grows into the root and the plumule grows into the shoot that produces leaves. So these complete are the life cycle of the plant, that from plants to seeds and seeds to plants. Now at last we have to revise this chapter, means what we had learned in this chapter, that plants are classified into three parts, that herbs, shrubs and trees. There are two main plant systems, shoot system and root system. Function of root system is to anchor plant to the soil and absorb minerals and water from the soil. And shoot system includes leaf, stem, flower and fruits. The function of leaf is transpiration and photosynthesis. Function of stem, to provide support pierce important parts of the plant and conduct water, minerals and prepare food. Function of flowers, that it helps in the reproduction in plants. And at last, function of fruits, that it protects the seeds and disperses the seeds. So that's all for today. I hope you all have understood the chapter very well. Thank you, students.